UNGA session. So first of all, I will ask how many of you have taken part in an MUN? Have previously. You may type out your answers if you have taken part in an international committee. Right. Okay. Okay, so we have 8 people who have taken part. So that is pretty great. But what I wanted to stress before we start off is that you have to a bit dissociate yourself from whatever you have learned previously. Because the procedure that you have learned, you might have be familiar with, is the UNA-USA procedure. And in this MUN, we will be following the Thymoon. Now, Thymoon is a really easy process to be followed. And I will start with the basics. So you will be needing to send two different things to me before the MUN, right? So we have our MUN on 2nd August. So on by 1st or by 31st July at 12 a.m., you need to send me the two things. So one will be the position paper. I'll be talking about it. The second one are the clauses, right? So the operational clauses. So what are operational clauses? So we have the agenda about discussing the credibility of World Health Organization, right? So here you will be requiring to send clauses, and I will share you some of the clauses that I had prepared last year at the... Can you all see my screen?
Yes, Akash.
Okay. So these were the clauses that I had sent, right? So I will break down the clauses for you. So this is the main clause. Okay. So this is the main clause, and A is the sub clause, right? So I have 4 sub clauses right over here. And this is the sub clause. So we have the main clause, the sub clause, and the sub clause. So it need not be so detailed every time. For example, in this clause, I just have the main clause and 3 sub clauses, right? So what the clauses basically are, these clauses are something which you are suggesting to be voted upon. So if you have taken part in an MUN, you must be knowing about the working papers, and later that is converted into a resolution. So that working paper contains clauses, and these clauses are nothing but solution. So even in Indian parliaments, we have the law, and law has clauses and sub clauses, right? So this is the similar way. The structure of a clause is that it starts with an action word right over here, and then we go over to the main clause. And then we have the sub clause and the sub clause. You have to send these to me. There is no restriction on the number of clauses that you need to send. But if you keep it to the minimum and improve the quality, that is highly recommended. Because if you are sending more quantity over quality, quality wins the race in this types of MUNs. Because we won't have very much time to discuss every clause. So the clause which are well formed are the ones that can be taken up. Okay. So so this is the basics about the clauses. Is there any doubts over here about how you form the clause? The clause are solutions which you can propose. Is there any doubt you can... Yes, Tareka, we will answer that question. Are there any doubts about clauses? Have you understand what clauses are? So, for example, last year I had healthcare of refugees as one of the agendas. So, I had stresses upon the need for development of the Rakhine state under the following categories. So, I had healthcare, economy, citizenship. Then I had strongly urges the Myanmar government to create a joint commission to resolve border issues and bilateral relation with Bangladesh, because I was a delegate of Bangladesh, right? So this is how I made the main clause and the sub clauses. So you need to send these on, I would say, on 1st August at midnight. So not on 2nd August, but 31st July midnight. Am I clear with this? Yes. Leeladhar, we have only these clauses while preparing. So what, I will like to clarify over here. So in Thai Moon, what we have is these all clauses that pass individually will be added to the UNGA final resolution, right? So for example, this clause as a whole, this one clause as a whole, which I have underlined, will be debated upon together, will be passed together, and will be called upon for amendment together. So in the normal type of MUN, what we have is we have motions, and on the second day we have the clauses. But in Thai Moon type of procedures, we start off with the clauses. So it is really easy for you to first acquaint yourself with the solutions, and then we can move into the debate. So I hope, Leeladhar, I have answered your question, that we will be starting off with the clauses. Yeah, okay. The second one is your position paper. So, okay, I will show the position paper as well. So what position paper is, you have to create a position paper keeping in mind your country. Right, so a general overview or the general format for a position paper will be, you have to first write the committee. In this case, we have the United Nations General Assembly. Then it will be followed by the agenda of the committee. Next will be the country you represent. Just a second, I'll show you the position paper. After that, you will have the opening part of the document. Right. Okay. So you all can see over here, we have the committee followed by the topic and later the country. Right. So I have divided my position paper into four paragraphs. The number one, the first paragraph is about what the topic, like an overview of the topic. What is the actual issue at hand? The second paragraph is about how is it affecting my country, and how. And the third paragraph will be how my country is views on it. So for example, we have United States. So United States will be questioning how WHO solved the issue, and China would be countering USA's claim about this. So this is just an example. You are free to find your own allies, like you have to find your own allies and opponents, and then we can that will be something that will be marked. Okay, so I think I have told what a position paper is. So you have committee, topic, country, then it will be a basic overview. The second paragraph would be about how is it affecting your country, and the third paragraph will be how your country proposes something. The third paragraph content is how your country would suggest something. So both the suggestions as well as what it is currently doing, right? So that will be the position paper. I would like everyone to not just copy paste the data of coronavirus cases, because that is not something that I would be looking for in a position paper. You need to form your own opinion as a country whenever you are coming to an MUN, because anyone can copy paste data and say this is the death rate and this is the number of vaccines we are producing. But how you propose and how you are how your country looks forward to the agenda. For example, there will be some allies of China and there will be some opponents of China, and similar for every other country. So all of those countries will have to give their position that, okay, we support this. So that can also come in a position paper. Right. So it should not be highly factual that you are only stressing upon what your country has done. It is also how your country is aligning with other countries. So this clears the two important things that you have to submit it to me. So is there any question on the position paper? I think there are none. Okay, now let's move toward the debate. How we going to take the debate? So I have prepared. Okay. Just a second, I will. Okay, no worries, I'll present my entire screen. You all can see my screen, right?
Yes, Akash, you are present.
Okay. Right, so this is how we are going to proceed with the debate. Okay, so first of all, like I said,
can I request you to please zoom in?
Yeah, I've zoomed in. Can you see it? Zoomed in?
Yes. Okay. Cool. Yes.
Okay. So what I have written here is, so how will the debate go? Right. So in a normal MUN, you usually have the general speakers list, right? So in this case, we will not be having any general speakers list. From all of the clauses that you send to me, I will be selecting the clauses and putting them in order in a PowerPoint presentation. So you will be having your clause as a whole into the PowerPoint. So for example, we have the delegate of North Korea whose clause is selected to be presented, right? So the clause, the country who has submitted the clause, their clause will be displayed on the screen, and then they will come and present their clause, right? So for example, the delegate of North Korea suggests a few things. For example, one in the clause titled XYZ, they have two sub clauses. So all of those will be presented together. So like I said, all of this is just one clause. So this will be debated upon as a whole. So for example, if delegate of North Korea has suggested this, the delegate of North Korea will be called upon to speak on the clause as a whole, right? So the delegate of North Korea is free to read the clause, and it's better not to read the clause, but just to speak on the main highlighting points of the clause, so that the committee is aware about what is the solution at hand, right? So after the after this is over, for example, North Korea is called to the dais. So the North Korea is given a certain amount of time that will be at my discretion. I can ask the delegate to conclude, okay? Or I can set a time, that will depend. The second is the delegate who has submitted the clause. For example, in our example, we have North Korea. So the North Korea delegate will be asked if they have any points of information that they would like to ask. The delegate of North Korea will be asked if he or she is open to any points of information. And if the delegate is open, the delegate will be asked how many points of information is the delegate open to. Right. So I will be asked, delegate of North Korea, are you open to any points of information? The delegate of North Korea has two options. Either the delegate of North Korea can refuse no, or the delegate of North Korea can say yes, I am open to 5 points of information or 3 points of information. Or the delegate can say I am open to any and all points of information. So what are points of information? So points of information are basically questions which you are asking the other delegate. Now you need to remember that points of information have to be in a form of a question. So you cannot give your comment without asking a question. So you have to, you are at a liberty to give one comment followed by a question. But a question is must. So there should be a question. It cannot be a general comment. For example, a delegate of India says that delegate of India disagrees with delegate of North Korea. So that will not be a valid point of information. You need to ask a point of information in a form of a question. So it can be a WH question or it can be an how question. Second, you are allowed to make a comment, but the comment has to be followed by a question. And it has to be kept short so that it is the chair and the delegate to whom the question is addressed knows what the question is. Right? So there, the delegate will be asked. So for example, delegate of North Korea went on to present their clause. Then they will be asked, are they open to any points of information? For example, delegate of North Korea says they are open to 4 points of information, and points of information are nothing but questions. So the delegate says, I am open to 4 questions or 4 points of information. Then I will ask, are there any delegates who want to ask questions or points of information? And then delegate will have to raise their hand in the Zoom. Like there is a raise hand feature. So you can click that. So you will raise your hand. I will recognize the delegates, and in that order, you will be able to ask your questions. So for example, I recognize delegate of India, USA, China. So all of these countries will be asking questions to North Korea one by one. So delegate of India will ask, delegate of North Korea will reply, then so on. So after this points of information end, after the points of information are over, the main submitter, for example, in this case, North Korea, will return back to their seat. Okay, now what will happen is there is a clause on the floor that has been proposed by North Korea and everyone can read it, right? Now I will open the floor for any speeches regarding the clause. So you can say this part is like the general speakers list. So the delegate of North Korea has displayed a clause. You can come up onto the dais and speak either for the clause, against the clause, or stay neutral, right? So you are allowed to speak on the clause as a whole. For example, you will be given 90 seconds to make your speech. So you can come up on the dais and say that I disagree with this, I disagree with this, this is not correct, this is not the correct. So we are speaking about the clause. So the delegate can give his arguments either for the clause or against the clause. And that is how his speech of 90 seconds will be over. So after North Korea sits down, I will open the floor for any speeches on the clause as a whole. So any delegates who wish to speak may raise their hands and I will recognize them. Okay. Right. I will answer all of these questions. Okay. Yes, the delegate can say to answer the question later, but that could reflect on their marks. Not much, but yes, the delegate can choose to answer the question later via chits. Okay, so the main submitter will be asked to return back to his seat. We'll have, yeah. Now, okay. Now, like I said, the floor was open for arguments. Now, there are two types of main arguments you can raise. Number one is, like I said, that any delegate can be recognized and they can come and speak for or against the clause at hand, the clause of North Korea. Right, and thereafter, what we will do is the delegates can write a chit, and the chit has to be in a digital format, typed on WhatsApp, and send it on the WhatsApp group. Okay, so what the chit has to be, the chit has to be an amendment to the clause. So I will tell you how the amendment is to be made, right? So, for example, you look at, okay, so I'll consider this clause, which is a bit simpler. Okay, so how the amendment would be. So, you will be typing in the WhatsApp group. You will type from, suppose Russia suggests the amendment. to ED amendment, then we have, you have a few options, right? So you can say delete clause 2A. So either you can say delete clause 2A, or you can say after discuss in clause 2A, add new, just an example. So here, after discuss, your request is to add a word new, right? So, or you can say delete, add or delete something. So it's obvious that the one you have to delete would include a current word that is existing, and adding is something that you wish to add, right? So now, like I said, there are two options. After the floor is open to discuss the clause as a whole, you have two options. Either you suggest an amendment and send it to the chair, and then you raise your placard. So for example, like I said, delegate of Russia proposes this amendment. So delegate, so when I ask, are there anyone who wishes to speak on the clause as a whole, then delegate of Russia can raise their hand. And then the delegate of Russia will be asking, has the amendment suggested by the delegate of Russia been received by the chair? And if the chair has received the amendment, that amendment will be put to question, right? So we have the main clause. I will open the floor for debates. So anyone can come speak for, speak against. And if you don't wish to speak for or against, what you can do is you can type in amendments and you can send those amendments. And that amendments will be taken up and those amendments will be discussed, right? So for example, delegate of Russia sent this amendment, and the delegate of Russia says that has the chair received the amendment sent by delegate of Russia? And I say yes. Now delegate of Russia has the floor for 1 minute to discuss the amendment. So the delegate of Russia can say that, okay, the delegate of Russia wishes to delete clause 2A because it is not relevant to the discussion, or they can raise any arguments they wish. Okay, so after the delegate of Russia is allowed to speak, similarly, the delegate of Russia will be asked, is the delegate of Russia open to any points of information or not? So anyone who comes on the dais will be asked if they are open to points of information or not. I hope I am making sense. I think this is a bit tricky once we do not get the hold of it. Are people having any doubts? Okay, I will consider that as a no. Okay, so delegate of Russia proposed an amendment, and that amendment will be discussed. So I will call delegate of Russia to come on the dais and to speak about the amendment, right? So after the delegate of Russia completes their speech, I will ask the delegate, is the delegate open to points of information? The delegate might refuse. The delegate might say yes and 4 points of information. Then I will recognize 4 questions like I did for the main clause. Even for the amendment that has been raised, I will be recognizing questions. So after that, delegate of Russia has made his speech on the amendment, and the delegates of other countries have asked delegate of Russia their points of information. Now the committee will move into voting on the amendment, right? So in the voting, what we will have is either you can vote for, either you can vote against, or you can abstain from voting. So I will talk about this once more once I discuss the roll call specifics. Okay. So either you can vote for the amendment, you can vote against the amendment, or you can abstain from voting. So now here I will be considering simple majority. So once there is simple majority, the amendment will pass, and the amendment, the clause by the North Korea will be amended by the clause of added, deleted, anything by the amendment of Russia. So So here we are still in the time of the debate of the clause as a whole. So again, I will open the floor that are there any more speakers to speak on the clause? So delegates might come forward and say, okay, I wish to speak for or against the clause. So that delegate will be invited onto the dais. So like I said, there are two options when I say the floor is open for debate on the clause as a whole. Either you can propose an amendment and then speak, or even if you don't want to propose an amendment, you can directly go on the dais and speak for or against. Anyone who goes on the dais will be asked if he or she is open to points of information or not. Okay, so I think this part is clear. So either you can send in an amendment and then speak, or you can even without sending an amendment, you can speak. I think this part is over. Are there any questions regarding to this? Yes, friendly amendment, unfriendly amendment. Okay. Preferential order, clause by two countries. Okay, so I will start from the top question. So Tarika has asked, will be following simple majority? Yes, we'll be following simple majority. Yeah, just one more thing. So after all of this is over, that is the amendments are over and the debate time has elapsed. So each time I take up a clause, for example, I take the clause of taken the clause of North Korea, right? So there I will be asking, there I will be setting a debate time, for example, 10 minutes to debate on the clause as a whole. So during that time, you need to suggest amendments. During that time, you need to give speeches for or against. During that time, you have to ask points of information. So everything has to be done within that 10 or 15 minutes that I said. And that time, once it elapses, we will now move on to the second clause and everything will be repeated. So suppose Delegate of India has proposed a clause. So Delegate of India will be called. He will be asked if he is open to points of information or not. See, if he says four, so four people will be recognized. Then the Delegate of India will sit. Then we will have amendments, and then people will giving their speech on amendments. The person who gives the speech on amendment will be asked any points of information. After he answers, then we will have general speeches. So it's not that the one who has suggested amendment will be recognized first, or the one who is going to give a speech will be recognized first. The recognition will be based on my discretion, in addition to the how fast you raise your hand. So if Delegate of India raises his hand before Delegate of China, it's not that because Delegate of China has sent in an amendment, I will recognize them first. That is not the issue. So this is how the clause is discussed. So after the debate time for the North Korea clause elapses, I will put the North Korea's clause into voting. There also, you require a simple majority to pass the resolution. Yes, so answering Chehek's question about friendly and unfriendly amendment. So we are not following the UNA-USA procedure. So we will only be following the Thaimun procedure. Now in Thaimun procedure, we do not have friendly and unfriendly amendments. So it will purely depend upon how you convince others not to vote for someone, right? So that will be the lobbying. So the delegate who proposes the clause does not have a right to ask or say that this is an unfriendly amendment, hence it will be put to vote. All types of amendment, even if it's friendly, unfriendly, every amendment will be put to vote. I think that answers your question, Chehek. Because what Chehek is asking is that in normal MUNs, what we have is, we have the delegate answering the one who proposes the clause that whether it's friendly or unfriendly. And only if it's unfriendly, it's put to vote. If it's a friendly, it's accepted directly. But in this case, all types of amendment will be put to vote. Yeah. So Tarika asks, even if it's a friendly amendment, who suggested it will be go through? Yeah. So every person who suggests an amendment, So they will have to raise their placard and say that has the chair received the amendment, and then I will be recognizing them. They will speak on the amendment and then they will be open to POIs. Okay, so Leeladhar, there is very less probability that two clauses are verbatim the same. So if two clauses are nearly the same, I will be choosing the clause. The question, I will be typing it again for those who might not have read the question. So this is what Leeladhar is asking. So if we have two countries which are proposing similar type of clauses, now I will select the clause which is more detailed or which is less, which is more robust. So what your role as a delegate would be to form robust clauses. Okay, so I will give you an example, but I expect that you do not have